Magandang umaga po mga kapatid sa Good Neighbor Christian Fellowship. Ito po ang ikalawang linggo ng July at tayo po ay nagpapasalamat sa Panginoon sa pagkakataon na magkasama-sama tayo minsan pa sa online worship service ng ating pong simbahan. Saan man po kayo naroon sa Pilipinas o sa iba't ibang bahagi ng mundo, tayo po ay nagpapasalamat na sa kabila ng tumataas na cases ng COVID-19 ay walang nakakahadlang sa mga ginagawa ng Panginoon sa ating buhay. Para po sa buong ito, ang ating pong theme ay Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving. And for today, ang ating pong lesson ay pinamagatan po nating Forever Grateful. Forever Grateful. Ang ating pong text ay ating pong mababasa sa aklat po ng Luke chapter 17 verses 11 to 19. Luke chapter 17 verses 11 to 19. Pero bago po tayo bumasa, tayo po muna ay sandaling manalangin. Panginoon, salamat po sa wisdom na iyong ipinagkakaloob sa aming pong chairman on how to navigate the continuing problem of COVID-19 in our country. With the cases going up in Metro Manila and many places, not just in the Philippines but in many parts of the world. And people's vaccine shots are waning in effectiveness. We are looking into trying to protect the safety and health of our senior citizens among us. And so please continue to guide your children, continue to bless your children, and continue to find ways, O Lord, for us to continue our service to you and our ministry to one another, sharing the good news of God's word. And we know that you will always be there for us until this whole problem of COVID-19 is done away with. So God, we ask that you bless our studies in the word of God this morning. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Para po sa ating pag-aaral this morning, I'd like to invite you to read with me from the book of Luke, chapter 17, verses 11 to 19 from the Good News Bible, today's English version. Ito po ang ating mababasa. As Jesus made his way to Jerusalem, he went along the border between Samaria and Galilee. He was going into a village when he was met by 10 men suffering from leprosy, a dreaded skin disease. They stood at a distance and shouted, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." Jesus saw them and said to them, "Go and let the priests examine you." On the way, they were made clean. When one of them saw that he was healed, he came back, praising God in a loud voice. 16, he threw himself to the ground at Jesus' feet and thanked him. The man was a Samaritan. Jesus spoke up. "There were 10 men who were healed. Where are the other 9? Why is this foreigner the only one who came back to give thanks to God?" And Jesus said to him, "Get up and go. Your faith has made you well." May the Lord bless the reading of His holy word. Mga kapatid, ang ating pong focus sa buwan ng July ay pasasalamat or thanksgiving. And there are many ways that we can express to God our hearts full of gratitude, our hearts full of thanksgiving. Subalit mga kapatid, sometimes sa kabila ng mga pagpapala ng Diyos ay nakakalimutan natin yung magpasalamat. Isang example po niyan ay ito pong 10 ketongin, the 10 lepers. Nung si Jesus po ay nagda-travel between Galilee and Jerusalem, siya po ay dadaan ng Samaria, Judea and Samaria. At sa kanya pong pagpasok sa isang village, siya po ay sinalubong ng 10 ketongin. Alam niyo po, sa panahon ng New Testament, ang mga ketongin, they live in a community on their own sapagkat sila po ay outcast from society. Yan pong sakit na yan ay very contagious. At incurable noong mga panahon yun. Hindi, wala pong gamot at malakas makahawa. At alam po natin mga kapatid, ang idea niya nakakahawa sapagkat ang, kapag ang sakit po talaga ay nakakahawa, talagang pwede mo pong ma-infect yung mga tao sa iyong paligid. So they were outcasts. They live outside the general population and they have their own community in some secluded place. They survive on their own. They cannot be visited by their families and they cannot visit their families until they are healed. And because many of them are suffering so bad, many of them just die in loneliness and despair. Kaya po, ang tanging paraan lamang para sila makabalik sa kanilang mga family ay yung sila'y gumaling. Pero dahil nga po walang cure, walang treatment nung panahon yun, ang leprosy o ketong, they really are hopeless. But these people find hope in Jesus Christ. And that is exactly what we want the world to know and we want the world to hear. Yes, your situation may be hopeless right now, but there is hope in Jesus Christ. Whether your problem is sickness, whether your problem is finances, whether your problem is emotional or spiritual, whatever is your problem and need, there is hope in Jesus Christ. Maybe your friends have told you your case is hopeless. Maybe other people around you are giving up on you, but God will never give up on us. Kaya po itong sampung ketongin, nung makita nilang dumarating ang Panginoon, they shouted to the Lord Jesus Christ. Ang sabi po niya, Jesus, Master, have pity on us. Now, sa kanila pong mga salita, there is already faith. Alam niyo naman po yung mga kalaban ng Panginoon itong panahon to, mga religious leaders and other mga dignitaries and mga elite ng Jewish society. They don't believe in Jesus. They will not listen to Jesus. They will not come near Jesus. They will not call upon Jesus. They hate him. They wanted to put him to death. They wanted to ask Pilate to crucify him. But here, these 10 lepers, hopeless as they are, destitute as they are, pitiful as they are, they shouted to the Lord Jesus from a distance, Jesus, Master, that is faith, that is submission, that is embrace, that is putting their belief in God. Jesus, Master, have pity on us. Now, God is a God of mercy. God is a God of compassion, and they know that. Kaya nga po mga kapatid, huwag po tayong mag-atubili anuman ang ating pagkukulang, kasalanan, pagkakamali, anuman ang ating kalagayan, whether that is self-inflicted or we're just victims of circumstances of life. Jesus, Master, have pity on us. And you can be sure that God will not withhold His compassion or mercy. Sabi nga po dun sa Lamentations chapter 3, 23-24, the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. Verse 14, and so Jesus saw them and said to them, go and let the priest examine you. Now that is, to us now, kind of like a strange reply. But if you know the Old Testament, you know that for you to be able to go back to your family and your community, for you to be able to be declared clean and worthy to go back to normal life, you have to show yourself to the priests. In the book of Leviticus, you will see that. Na kailangan mong ipakita ang sarili mo sa priest and the priest will examine you if you are healed, if you are well, if you are clean, if you are worthy to go back to your community. And if the priest see that you are healed and clean, then the priest will give the authorization for you to go back to your family. And so that's why Jesus said, go and let the priest examine you. Now, if you do not have faith in the words of Jesus, you will not do that. Because you know you cannot do that. You cannot do that because if you have lepers, you cannot show yourself to the priest. You will be stoned. People will stone you. The priest will stone you himself because that's the penalty for coming near the community or going into the community when you are lepers. You will be stoned. So the fact that Jesus told them, go and show yourself to the priests. And they went. They went. That is hope. That is faith. That is trust. They have learned to trust in Jesus. Sabi niya po sa Proverbs chapter 3 verses 5 to 8, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not in your own understanding. Your understanding says, you're a leper. You're unclean. You cannot go there yet. But you trust in the Lord with all your heart. You don't lean in your understanding in all your ways. You acknowledge Him. You acknowledge Him as your master. You acknowledge Him as your healer. You acknowledge Him as your God. And so therefore, go in faith. And they went. So on the way, they were made clean. So alam niyo mga kapatid, yung pananampalataya, dapat you act on it. You don't sit and wait. You act on it. Sabi ka nila, pag daw ikaw ay nanalangin ng ulan, abay magdala ka ng payong. Bakit ka magdala ng payong? Sapagkat nagtitiwala ka na yung panalangin mo ay tutugunin ng Diyos. So pag nanalangin ka ng ulan, at nagtitiwala ka na didinggin ng Diyos ang panalangin mo, magdala ka ng payong. Para pag ulan, according to your prayers, meron kang payong. In the same way, pag ikay nananalangin sa Panginoon ng blessings, abay buksan mo yung iyong lalagyan ng blessings. Para pag bumagsak yung blessings, ready. Ready kang sapuhin ang mga blessings ng God. It's a response to faith. In this case, nasabi ng Panginoon, go show yourself to the priest. And they went trusting in the words of Jesus. And on the way, they were made clean. Exactly. Trust and obey, for there's no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. Trust in the words of God. Trust in the promises of God and obey. Jesus said, go and show yourself to the priests. They trust and they went in obedience. And on the way, they received their miracles. On the way, they received their healing. On the way, they received the power of God. Now, verse 15, when one of them saw that he was healed, he came back. Nung makita niya siya pinagaling ng Panginoon, siya ay bumalik. Isa sa sampo ay nakaalalang bumalik. Anong ginawa niya? He came back praising God in a loud voice. He was probably shouting and screaming and thanking God. Oh God, praise the Lord. Thank you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He was probably shouting loud, praising God in a loud voice. And when he got back to the Lord Jesus, verse 16, he threw himself to the ground at Jesus' feet. And what? Thank him. He was so happy. He was so excited. He was so thankful. He threw himself to the ground and thanked the Lord Jesus at his feet. Mga kapatid, you would say this must be the most godly among the 10 sapagkat yung Siyam umuwi na. Yung Siyam nag-enjoy na sa buhay nila kasama ng pamilya, nagbalik na sa kanilang buhay sapagkat sila'y pinagpala ng Diyos, pinagaling ng Diyos, pero nakalimutan nilang magbalik ng pasasalamat. But not this man. And this man is no special because in their case, they look down on this man because this man was a Samaritan. A Samaritan is someone who is not pure-blooded Jew. Rather, a Samaritan is an outcast sa kanila po society. Not only because he was a leper, but because he was a Samaritan. Hindi siya pure Jewish-blooded man under the covenant of God. But even then, this man so despised, remember the goodness of God and have the heart to come back and give thanks, to say thanks. Mga kapatid, alam ko marami sa inyo nag-i-enjoy ng blessings ng Diyos, nag-i-enjoy ng goodness ng Diyos, ng mercy and compassion and love, nag-i-enjoy ng protection ng Diyos. But have you ever pause in your journey. Come back to the presence of God and say, thank you, Lord, for all your blessings. Thank you, Lord, for all your goodness. Thank you, Lord, for your mercy. Thank you, Lord, for your protection. And how did Jesus respond? Verse 17, Jesus spoke up. There were 10 men who were healed. Ina-acknowledge ni Jesus. Alam niya kung ano ang kanyang ginawa. Alam niya kung ilan ang kanyang pinagaling. There were 10 men who were healed. Where are the other 9? Para ba sinasabi ng Panginoon, oh, lahat yang mga taga-Good Neighbor, pinagpala ko. Lahat yang mga nakikinig sa kanilang online services, pinagpala ko. Lahat yang mga kapartner ng GNCF, pinagpala ko. Pero nasaan yung iba? Bakit hindi nagpapasalamat? Nasaan yung iba? Bakit hindi nagbabalik ng kanilang pagpupuri? Nasaan ang kanilang pagkilala sa kagandahang loob ng Diyos? So ladies and gentlemen, hinahanap ng Diyos, nasaan yung ibang pinagpala? Ikaw ba'y kasama sa pinagpala ng Diyos? Ikaw ba'y kasama sa tumanggap ng kagandahang loob ng Diyos? Ikaw ba'y kasama sa mga ginabayan at iningatan ng Diyos? Hinahanap niya ang iyong pagbabalik ng pagpupuri at pasasalamat sa kanyang kagandahang loob. God is looking for you and waiting for you to come back and say thanks and give thanks. Ang sabi niya, verse 18, why is this foreigner the only one who came back to give thanks to God? Bakit? Kung sino pa yung despised, yung looked down, bakit siya lang ang nakaalala na bumalik at magpasalamat sa Diyos? Why? Bakit? So bakit tayo hindi bumabalik? Bakit hindi tayo nakakaalala? Bakit hindi man lang natin ibigay sa Kanya ang karapat-dapat nating ibigay ang pagpupuri at pagpapasalamat? Why is this foreigner the only one who came back to give thanks to God? Verse 19, and Jesus said to him, get up and go. Your faith has made you well. Go! Nandun po yung blessing ng Diyos sa kanya. Get up, go. Your faith has made you well. Mga kapatid, marami pang darating na pagpapala dito sa Samaritan man. Marami pang magandang kalooban ng Diyos at kagandahang loob ng Diyos ang ma-encounter at mararanasan nitong Samaritan na nagpasalamat. I'm not sure about the other 9. Maybe the other 9 are rejoicing back in their families. But that may be the last thing they received from God. Because they forgot to give glory and honor to God. They forgot to thank Him. They even forgot to come back to Him. But if you keep going back to God in thanksgiving and praise and worship and service, you keep coming back to God every day of your life. You keep coming back to God. Let me tell you, go! And there are more waiting for you. More blessings, more manifestations of God's power and glory, more goodness and mercy. Sabi nga po yan doon sa Psalm 23 verse 6, surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. If you do not forget to give God the glory, if you do not forget to give God the recognition and the acknowledgement and the honor and the praise, goodness and mercy will follow you all the days of your life here on earth. And when this life is over, you will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Isn't that a wonderful promise? So please, come back and give thanks. Please, come back. Lay yourself down to the feet of Jesus and acknowledge Him as your Lord and Savior and Master, Provider, Healer, Great God, Savior. And there will be more blessings coming your way. More goodness and mercy coming your way. More power and presence of God coming your way. Oh, let's not forget to give thanks to God. Let us pray. Oh, we thank you. We praise you. We give you our highest praise and highest thanks this morning as we remember all of the things you've done. The healing, the miracles, the provisions, the protection, the guidance and the mighty presence of God that gives us peace and joy, and goodness and mercy. Oh, we thank you, Father. We are forever grateful because we have received eternal life from you, forgiveness of sin from you. And we are thankful, not just for today, but every day and forever. We are thankful, forever we are grateful to you. You are a wonderful God we serve, a mighty God we serve, a faithful God we serve. And so help us, O Lord, sa kabila ng pandemic, sa kabila ng crisis, sa kabila ng danger, sa kabila ng lahat ng nangyayaring kahirapan at kaguluhan sa sanlibutan, we are here, we're coming back, we're laying down before your feet to give you thanks forever and ever and ever. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Salamat po sa inyong pag-join sa ating pong gawain ngayon online. At patuloy po nating subaybayan ang mga announcement po ng ating chairman, Pastor Armando Santos, para po sa ating pong ang mga activities in the coming weeks. May mga Sunday po na tayo ay face-to-face, may mga Sunday po na tayo ay online. Depende po sa kalagayan ng ating pong pagharap sa hamon po ng COVID-19. At atin pong tatandaan at huwag kakalimutan, kasama natin ng Diyos, iingatan tayo ng Diyos. So humayo tayo ng may kapayapaan sa ating pong mga puso. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you His peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Everybody say, Amen. Amen. God bless you all.